the top 6 vitamins to lower your blood pressure. High blood pressure is a condition where your heart is working harder than normal to pump blood and oxygen throughout your body. Over a long period of time, this extra pressure can start damaging the inside walls of your arteries, and this causes them to become very stiff and rigid rather than being flexible. Eventually, this can trigger a blockage and it can raise your risk of having a heart attack, a stroke, or even a blood clot. So if you go and get your blood pressure checked and there's a reading of 140 over 90 or above, and this stays the same for a few days, this is classed as high blood pressure. But what exactly is causing this high blood pressure in the first place? Well, the main cause is having high levels of a hormone called insulin in your blood, which stimulates a part of your nervous system that raises your blood pressure. The reason that you have too much insulin is because you're eating too many refined carbohydrates like sugar, soda drinks, breads, cereals, cakes, and all of the flour-based foods. Also, you'll find that if you're not getting enough potassium in your diet, this can cause fluid retention, which puts pressure on your arteries and heart, raising up your blood pressure. Another one of the main causes of high blood pressure or hypertension is high cortisol levels, a hormone that's released when you feel stress or tension or fear. You also need regular exercise to keep your heart muscle strong and healthy. So if you aren't exercising, the heart muscle can get weaker and have to work much harder. And also, simply being deficient in magnesium, vitamin C, or vitamin D can make your arteries very tight and restricted. So again, the heart has to work harder, bringing up the blood pressure. Now, if you go to your doctor, they'll often prescribe drugs like ACE inhibitors, beta blockers, and calcium channel blockers to help lower your blood pressure. The problem is that these drugs have many different side effects because they deplete your antioxidants and your mineral reserves, which can make the problem even worse over time. Fortunately, however, there are some vitamins that you can use to lower your blood pressure naturally by treating the root causes of the problem and not just covering up the symptoms. In this video, we'll be exploring the top 6 vitamins to lower your blood pressure naturally. Bear in mind that I use the words vitamins very broadly to include minerals, herbal remedies, and nutritional supplements that you can use to lower your blood pressure. Just a quick reminder, this video is for educational purposes only, so do speak to your doctor if you have any medical concerns. The first item on my list is a combination of vitamin D3 with K2. You may not realize it, but billions of people worldwide are deficient in vitamin D, which has been shown to raise the blood pressure and also cortisol levels, which is the stress hormone. Vitamin D helps to relax both the smooth muscle in your arteries and the thick muscle in the middle layer of your heart in order to lower your blood pressure. If you wish, you can take 20,000 IUs of vitamin D3 per day, along with 200 micrograms of vitamin K2 in the form of MK7. These will boost vitamin D levels in your body and naturally lower your blood pressure. Please make sure that you include the vitamin K2, as this works with the vitamin D to move calcium around your body, preventing it from hardening your artery walls and making blood pressure worse. You can also naturally boost your vitamin D by exposing your skin to the sunshine for at least 45 minutes each day. Number 2 is niacin, one of the best remedies to prevent heart attacks. If you suffer from high blood pressure, clogged arteries, or high LDL cholesterol, then you may consider taking B3 on a daily basis to help prevent a heart attack or a stroke. Niacin, or vitamin B3, has been well studied for its ability to vasodilate the blood vessels, basically helping them to open up and allow the blood to flow freely through your body without restriction. It also helps to prevent inflammation and plaque from forming inside your artery walls. If you wish to take this, a good dosage is between 500 to 1000 milligrams of extended release niacin per day. You'll find that between 30 to 120 minutes after taking this, you may feel this flushing sensation of heat or a rush of blood to your face and neck. This is the niacin triggering prostaglandins, which are opening up your blood vessels. allowing the blood to flow better through your body. Please make sure that you don't purchase the non-flushing niacin, as this will not have the same effect. I also recommend getting B3 or niacin into your diet naturally by eating nutritional yeast, salmon, turkey, and anchovies. If you're finding this information helpful, please hit the like, subscribe, and turn all notifications on to stay updated with health and nutrition tips. Coming back now to number 3, which is two very important minerals called potassium and magnesium. Now, potassium is a mineral which works with sodium, or salt, to balance out the fluids in your body. Unfortunately, many people consume high amounts of salt and not enough potassium from leafy green vegetables, which causes their bodies and their cells to start swelling up with fluid. This extra fluid retention puts extra pressure on the vascular system and the arteries, triggering high blood pressure, along with other heart problems like skipped beats or a high pulse rate. Like potassium, magnesium is also another key electrolyte mineral which helps your heart to relax and contract, to pump blood around your body at the normal rate. Loading up on potassium and magnesium helps to fix the root causes of high blood pressure by lowering the stress hormone called cortisol, lowering insulin, the blood sugar hormone, and also supporting the pacemaker of your heart, which is called the SA node. These minerals all come from leafy green vegetables like Brussels sprouts, cabbage, arugula, beet tops, collard greens, broccoli, avocados, and pumpkin seeds. But if you really want to raise your potassium and magnesium levels, you can purchase a high-quality electrolyte powder which contains at least 1,000 mg of potassium citrate and 100 mg of magnesium citrate, and you can drink these in a glass of water twice per day. Number 4 is a herbal remedy called aged garlic extract. Now, as you may know, garlic is one of the most healing foods on the planet, as it contains a powerful natural sulfur called allicin, which gives it that pungent flavour and smell. Aged garlic extract has been shown in many studies to naturally lower blood pressure by lowering angiotensin II. This is a hormone that usually constricts your blood vessels and raises up your blood pressure. Garlic extract works by boosting nitric oxide. It's a molecule that acts like a gas, and this dilates and opens up your blood vessels to help normalize your blood pressure. If you're looking for a herbal supplement like this, you can take 2400 milligrams of aged garlic extract on a daily basis to help lower your blood pressure and also reduce the risk of blood clots. I also recommend eating organic aged garlic called black garlic raw in salads and stir fries. It has a sweeter taste than regular garlic, and it has more antioxidants because it's been fermented. Number 5 is vitamin E in a form called tocotrienols. Many people are deficient in an antioxidant called vitamin E because they consume too many flour-based foods like bread, cereals, biscuits, pasta, etc. You see, when flour is baked and cooked, it oxidizes and it destroys all of the natural vitamin E, rendering it unavailable to your body. And it also depletes your own vitamin E reserves because it's missing from the food already. Without enough vitamin E, your heart struggles to use oxygen properly, raising the risk of chest pain or angina, where your heart may cramp, and a higher risk of stroke or inflammation in the coronary artery. If you wish, you can take up to 300 milligrams of vitamin E in the form called tocotrienols daily. Tocotrienols are a part of the vitamin E complex that are 50 times stronger than regular tocopherols found in common over-the-counter vitamin E tablets. You can also get vitamin E from foods such as sunflower seeds, avocados, hazelnuts, extra virgin olive oil, Swiss chard, and all of the leafy green vegetables. And the last one may surprise you, it's apple cider vinegar. As I previously mentioned, one of the main underlying causes of high blood pressure is high levels of the insulin hormone due to high blood sugars. So start drinking 1 tablespoon of apple cider vinegar mixed in a glass of water before each meal. The acetic acid in this vinegar is a short-chain fatty acid which helps to reduce insulin resistance, lower blood sugars, and therefore protect against damage in your artery walls. You can also mix it with a little extra virgin olive oil to make a tasty and healthy salad dressing, which will help your stomach to absorb more minerals like potassium and magnesium that we talked about earlier in the video. Later in the video, I'm going to share with you 6 lifestyle changes you can make to get your blood pressure under control and lower your risk of mortality. But first, let's take a look at a few signs to watch out for that may indicate that you already have high blood pressure. If you have lots of belly fat, consider getting your blood pressure checked, as the high levels of insulin that's forming your belly fat may also be raising your blood pressure. Also, if you have high blood pressure and one of your arteries has become clogged, you may have a pressure or a painful feeling in your chest, especially when you're emotionally stressed or you're exercising, and then the pain goes away again when you relax. And another sign is that you may feel that you can't catch your breath when you're walking up a flight of stairs, because your antioxidants are low and your blood pressure may be a little high. However, most of the time, people have no symptoms of high blood pressure at all, so it's important to check it regularly. You can purchase a blood pressure monitor to use at home, and I'll share a link to one of these in the video description below. Or you can simply visit your doctor or nurse for a simple checkup, but you'll need to check it daily for 3 days, because a blood pressure spike can be temporary, and this is not classed as hypertension. Now that you know all this, let's explore 6 lifestyle changes that you can make to truly get your blood pressure under control. 1. Cut back on caffeinated drinks like coffee, tea, and soda to less than 2 cups per day, as caffeine can stimulate cortisol, causing fluid retention and high blood pressure. Replace these with more antihypertensive teas, which will naturally lower your blood pressure, like hibiscus tea, chamomile, lavender, and rose herbal teas. 2. Eat foods that boost nitric oxide levels, such as beets, garlic, spinach, kale, leafy greens, beef liver, lemons, and watermelon. Your nitric oxide levels increase when you eat these foods, which makes your blood vessels open up to allow for better blood flow and to lower your blood pressure. 3. To further boost up your nitric oxide, start taking long, steady walks in nature for at least 45 minutes per day. Try to go in areas where there's lots of trees and plant life. This will also lower cortisol and improve the function of your heart. 4. Stay away from alcohol, cigarettes, and vape devices, as these will deplete your antioxidant reserves, damaging your heart and weakening your vascular system. 5. Start to improve your sleep by going to bed an hour earlier each night, turning off all forms of blue light like your phone and your television. Getting more sleep naturally relaxes the arteries and improves blood pressure by lowering both cortisol and insulin and raising nitric oxide. And 6. Start fasting for 16 hours per day and eat all of your regular calories in an 8-hour window. Say perhaps between 12 and 6 p.m. This is absolutely one of the best ways to reduce blood pressure, lower oxidative stress, and reduce the risk of clogged arteries. If you'd like to learn a little bit more about the top 10 foods that you can use to lower your blood pressure, go ahead and tap on this video on the screen now. Thank you so much for watching my video today, and as always, I wish you great health, wealth, and happiness.